Our first act tonight is the songwriting and singing engine room of the larger Adelaide-based indie folk pop band that go by the name Axe and the Ivory. They formed back in 2013. They're building a reputation for their intricate guitar melodies, harmonies, songwriting skills, and they featured at the Gorgeous Festival. They've played to sell-out crowds at the Weedy, supported by the Timbers and the Turning Circles, and their regular performers at the Grace Emily in Adelaide. Please welcome to the stage Ben Lovell and Rosie Roberts from Axe and the Ivory.
Asked the question, she said, don't know when, but I know it's coming round. So we carved a name into the sidewalk and we stopped halfway down. So young, we couldn't even read it, but we knew what it meant. So young, we couldn't even read it. Throw a party, invite everyone. Now your bald head is shining in the sun. Don't make me throw a party, invite everyone. Don't think about it, don't breathe in the water. Don't tell yourself you're gonna be okay. Don't breathe in the water, don't tell yourself you're gonna be okay. You're already swallowing the pill. She made me promise not to ask again, so she didn't have to hang her head in the void or answer it. Pretending not to know the things we knew were true, so we didn't have to lie again. So young, we couldn't even read it, but we knew what it meant. So young, we couldn't even read it, but we knew what it meant. Swallowing the pill. swallowing a pill. Already swallowing a pill.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Can I have a little bit more guitar in there? Thank you. Thanks, John. A bit more again, please.
Said I'm not the same as you. If only you knew what you're doing to me. If only you knew what you're doing to me. If only you knew what you're doing to me. If only you knew what you're doing to me. You move to the words, I move to the sounds. You hit yourself so quietly in cracks. You're only just finding your way out. And I wanna be a ballroom dancer. I wanna be a ballroom dancer like you. I wanna be a ballroom dancer. I wanna be a ballroom dancer like you. Saying I need a bed full of vacant people staring at the walls where the posts are keeping every one of them in line, packed in close, tucked in tight with your sardine arc and your dreams packed hard, and you're going slowly to the bottom of the ocean with me. Saying I only knew you were sinking with me. If only you knew you were sinking with me. If only you knew you were sinking with me. If only you knew you were sinking with me. So take it away. Worried about the clothes you wore. Have I got time to get dressed? No, I'm sorry. Gotta pack my life up in half an hour. 'Cause you need to be somewhere so soon. And then black bags on the dining room table. I'll give him the key. Saying I need a bed for the vacant people staring at the walls of the post, keeping every one of them in line, packed in close, tucked in tight with your sardine arc and your dreams packed hard, and you're going slowly to the bottom of the ocean. So I only knew you were sinking with me. If only you knew you were sinking with me. If only you knew you were sinking with me. If only you knew you were sinking with me. Take it away. I don't need it no more. I remember the times you caused me pain. 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 Saying I wanna be a ballroom dancer, I wanna be dance like you. I wanna be a ballroom dancer. I wanna be a ballroom dancer like you.
Thank you. So, my brother Jimmy's here from London, which is very exciting. In a lumberjack.
Thanks, Dad.
So yeah, is you singing the next one? Yes, you are. Yeah, this is a bit exciting. So this is called Let It Go. Do I have a story about it? No, I don't know. It's in the song. Just listen to the song. No, I don't.
That's letting something go.
I think so.
That is it.
It's not Barbara Bachchan, sorry. That's my daughter. I'm about to two songs from three that have had a new ending for you guys that we made up just then. Distracted as well, that's interesting. If we weren't distracted, we might have finished it.
the story behind this song is I went to see a lecture, an interview with the Thomas Keneally, the author of Schindler's Ark and millions of other books, and he was talking about how he publishes a book a year, so he's pretty prolific, and someone in the audience asked him, how does he know when a book is finished? And he said that, you know, basically there is no ending of a book, you just kind of get distracted and move on to the next thing. And kind of stuck with me for a few days because I thought that's actually pretty similar to life, I think. You try and finish things well, but often you get distracted and just move on. So that's what this song is about. Yes.
Not everything feels finished, just abandoned at some point. Distracted by a brightly colored bird on a wire, by the slowly fading embers of your last roll joint, by the absence that you live with after a week of dodge tights. So hold it up to the light. Pick it to pieces, we'll be here all night. Sleeping off on my floor, let the wheels keep on turning outside the bedroom door. We'll just tell them they got away with a little more.
Rosie and I learnt a different way, like a different cover. So there'll be some, yeah, some
actually,
different bits.
The truth is, Ben's been playing it the same way, listened to it the same way his whole life, and I just changed it, and now he's mad at me. So this is what
I'm not mad at you. You're just very naughty. No, I'm not mad.
Thank you.
wonder when I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on, but don't think twice, it's alright.
Rosie wrote a book, by the way, which is pretty cool. That's fantastic, isn't it? We don't have time to tell you the title of the book, I assume. But that's pretty cool. Come on. I actually don't know. It's like, I can't pronounce the words. What is it? Come on.
No, I'm not going to tell you about that.
Well, I'm not playing a...
I'll tell you about something else.
Okay.
I was thinking on the way up here today about this barn, and it's actually furnished a lot of my childhood daydreams. So it's actually kind of weird having a barn full of people here, because this is where I used to just hang out and play. And one of mine, I don't know if you guys, well, if you're parents of children of my age, the Alice and Lester books, Rosie Sips Spiders and Rosie Goes Droving, they were my favourite books as a kid. And I used to have this daydream about this barn where it would be Christmas Eve, everyone's in bed and everyone's sleeping, and our neighbour would come and knock on the door to tell us that all of our cows have got out. We don't actually have cows, but I'm a kid, so I'm imagining that we do. And they've all got out and run away, and I've run out barefoot in my pyjamas to the barn and grabbed my trusty steed, whose name was Tina, that bit is true, and gone out into the night and brought the cows home and effectively saved Christmas. So I used to... So that's my memory of this barn.
Anyway.
always brings out the waste. Love and lies, well, next to her, your favorite song, you mouth the words. Get it back, bring it back, when you held my attention. Get it back, bring it back, when you consume my affection.
John and Liz and Dan, you're such an amazing band, and it's such a privilege to be supporting you. So,
yes,
and also to Dave and John for mixing us. Thanks so much.
Thanks, guys. Thank you.
And I know that you will.
So bad.